you. Thank you very kindly. This is the Marshall Municipal Band doing our regular Wednesday evening band concert at Liberty Park. My name is Bob Meffert, and I did order this weather, as I said before, and sometimes we don't get it, but we did so far this year. Isn't this wonderful? Let's go for Monday night, too. Okay, we're doing a little flag waving in this concert. We're doing pre-4th of July stuff, so expect some of the patriotic tunes and stuff that you might hear on the 4th of July. We figured July 6th would be a little late, so we're doing some of that tonight. This first march was El Capitan, John Philip Sousa, so we got that out of the way in a hurry, didn't we? The Sousa march right away, back in the 1890s, 98, in the Spanish-American War and so on. Sousa wrote a musical called El Capitan, and this is a march from there. One of the rare marches that has 6/8 to start with, get ta 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 ta, and then go up, 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 2/4 time in the trio. So for those of you musically inclined, bi-meter march. Okay, we'll have our kids march a little later on. We have no guests this evening, so it's just all the band, and we'll try to give you a variety of music. And it's good to see Hal's pals here again. They leave a little earlier so they get off the road before it gets too dark and so on, but it's good to have them here. So welcome all you people from there and all the other of you. Next, we're going to do a number that we did, I think, 2 or 3 years ago. We were going to do it on the 4th of July, and that was the one that got rained out. It's the very famous American Patrol by F.W. Meacham. Glenn Miller kind of made it famous, popular with his popular jazz band version of American Patrol. But Meacham wrote a tune, and it's called American Patrol. It starts with that, with his original. And then he adds some old tunes in there, like Columbia, the Gem of the Ocean, or Red, White, and Blue. And Dixie gets stuck in there. And toward the end, if you listen very carefully, you might even hear Yankee Doodle. And we'll hear that a little later on Kids March. But it's all part of an American Patrol. Inc. I told you the Inky Doodle would show up in there someplace. American Patrol, all the familiar melodies, and just done up very well. American Patrol, Red, White, and Blue, Dixie, and Yankee Doodle by F.W. Meacham. We're going to go to another Carl King march at this point. Did I announce that this is the Marshall Municipal Band? My name is Bob Meffert, and I'm your announcer, and gives them a chance to change the clothespins. We don't need them very much tonight, but there was a little breeze. I almost had to keep a hand on mine out front here so I didn't lose it. The next march we're going to play is Carl King march, and he had longevity down at Fort Dodge, Iowa, directed the band there for some 51 years, and had his own publishing company and whatever, but he wrote a lot of marches. He emulated John Philip Sousa, but some of Sousa's marches were pretty tough, and school bands back in the 40s and 50s couldn't quite handle some of them very easily, so he wrote a bunch of marches that are sound great, but they're a little bit simpler, and school bands played an awful lot of them. This is one of them. It's called Call to Victory March, somewhat on a patriotic theme. Call to Victory March, Carl King. Victory March, Carl King. That's two pieces in a row now. You almost feel like you've been at a parade, right? that American Patrol, I forgot to mention that. That's kind of intended. It starts out very small, just a drum solo, and then the clarinets come to the boom, boom, and then it builds up in the middle as the band marches by, and it's right in front of you, and it's going full blast, and then as it goes away, it gets softer and softer and softer until that little surprise. Well, this one harkened me back to my drum and bugle corps days with that bugle call sound in the middle, right there in the break strain. Call to Victory March, Carl King. All right, going back to our heritage in the beginnings of our country, William Billings penned a tune that was called Chester, and it almost became our national anthem. It was, kind of was at that time, because our Star Spangled Banner didn't come along until 1812, right, or 14, somewhere in that territory. But this particular hymn-type tune was the rallying cry for the people back in those days, in the Revolutionary Day times. William Billings' Chester. Chester by Mr. Talmadge. That's for band people that would like to know where that arrangement comes from. One of our early national anthems. This is going to be a premiere this evening. For at least in the 50 years that I've been in the band, we have never played this piece before. And it's listed as a novelty. Herbert L. Fred is given the credit for making this arrangement. And we're going to go and hearken back to a tune that a lot of us sang maybe back in grade school, some of us white-haired people. When's the last time you heard, "I've been working on the railroad"? Oh, man. How about that? Okay, you get your jollies right now. This is all kinds of different melody. I didn't know that was going to have that kind of reaction. Okay. So we've added that to the library, and it's going to have different little styles, and slow and fast and jazz band style and all kinds of stuff. So here goes, hang on. I've been working on the railroad. Man, the band's on top of this better than I am. Right after this, we will have our weekly kids march. So boys and girls over on the swings and everybody else sitting around here, you can start gathering. As soon as we get done working on the railroad, we'll have to do the kids march, all right? I remember my grandpa Meffert retiring off the farm, moving to Arlington, and working on the section crew of the old Emmons Adel. that went up and down Highway 19 and into Excelsior. So he's driving spikes into the railroad ties and so on at 65. Holy cow. Amazing. He went to 95, so it mustn't have hurt him at all. I've been working on a railroad, a novelty number. All right, here we go. Yankee Doodle is our kids' march, and we don't see anybody out. Oh, here they come. All right, very good. And the girls will train you. Go around the metal park benches. Don't go around all those people with their own chairs out there. That would take forever, and you might get lost on the street, and you wouldn't want that either. But there'll be a sucker for you. If you have a young child who doesn't want to go by themselves, walk them around, carry them around, but let them walk around so that they do get the reward at the end. The sucker is the reward, and you wouldn't want anybody to miss out on that. Okay, there they are. This has been a tradition here for longer than 50 years, I can guarantee that. It's been as long as I've been in the band, but it started before that. It's probably about 60 years old, our kids' march. Okay, and we're going to do it on 4th of July festival type thing. George M. Cohan wrote the tune. It's called Yankee Doodle Boy. Out of Winona, Hal Leonard music and some of that. This is one of those swing ding things that came out in the early 60s that I was talking about. Really, really nifty arrangements used by school bands, and they sound great with the big bands that we have here too. Okay, now we're going to do a second premiere tonight, for heaven's sake. I've been looking for this piece for years and finally found an arrangement of it. I was almost ready to write my own, but I'm glad we found one. Saved me the time and probably wouldn't be near as good as this one. Anybody ever heard of the Teddy Bears Picnic? Okay, we finally found an arrangement of it, and tonight we're going to play it for you. John W. Bratton's The Teddy Bears Picnic. Mm-hmm. Winter's Picnic by John W. Bratton. Nice to have four tubas to help play the Bears, isn't it? Thank you. And our very sax player, too. Nick is just doing a great job up there. Okay, we're going to kind of change the mood a little bit right now and go back to a little bit of history also. Hal David and Burt Bacharach were a very famous songwriting team, words and music, and they wrote a number of them. I think the Carpenters were the ones that made this famous, or one of the ones, but we're going to do a slow ballad right now, pop song. They Long to Be Close to You. By two experts, and Hal David, Burt Bacharach, They Long to Be Close to You. Boy, are we going to change moods now. My goodness sakes, that nice slow ballad. And now we're going to go to Henry Fillmore. And he's the guy who wrote Lass's Trombone, and I think we played Shoutin' Liza earlier and so on. This is another one of the family. This one is called Slim Trombone. Not as familiar as all the rest, and so we're going to work at it. And we're going to play Henry Fillmore's one of the 13 in the family. This is called Slim Trombone, our trombone feature for the evening.
Thank you.
Slim trombone, relative or brother or sister of Lassus and Chum Liza and all the rest. Thank you guys and gals. No, the only fellas up there this year. Okay. Our trombone section, trombone feature for the evening, Henry Fillmore. Okay, now we're going to get patriotic for the last selections of the program. We're going to be pretty much traditional, our 4th of July concert. We're going to ask Brett Luaggi to come down and do Lee Greenwood's tune, the one that everybody really likes. I remember Lee Greenwood was back in town here at the Lyon County Fair somewhere in the early 90s, 91, 92, 93 or something, and sang this at our own grandstand at the Lyon County Fair. We're going to bring Brett Luaggi forward, and it's called God Bless the USA. just a little bit. Okay, that was Lee Greenwood's God Bless the USA with our own Brad Lawache. Thank you very much, Brad. I always get a chill when I've heard Lee Greenwood singing, and as far as I'm concerned, Brad sings it better than Lee. That's a personal opinion, but very good. Okay, we're going to go to another Carl King march, and I said this is really our patriotic section, and this one's called Our Heritage March, Carl King. Our Heritage March by Carl L. King. Patriotic selection, referring to our heritage. As I said, we do this again on Monday evening, only you'll have to go over to Independence Park because we play before the fireworks on Monday. They'll have the new municipal, shall we say, grandstand over there, the portable one that they used at Sound of the Summer last year. We have a roof. Finally, instead of just the wonderful platform that the county fair has, but we'll not only have that platform, but we'll have a roof over our heads to help with the sound, and I'm hoping that our new microphone setup is also helping out with that. So wear your red, white, and blue that evening, and right after that we'll be, well, as soon as it takes for us to get our stuff off the stage, then he'll have the magician, I believe, right? Magician. And then following that will be the fireworks. So if you want to hear some of this stuff again and a few other things, come on over Monday night, and that's at 7:30 as well. So everything we do is at 7:30. We rehearse on Tuesday night at 7:30, and we play on Wednesday night at 7:30 and the 4th of July, whenever that is. The next selection is a personal favorite of mine. I never forget the first time I heard it. I think it was one of the service bands, the Air Force Band or something of that nature. It's our America the Beautiful, and it's going to be our serious song for the evening. Samuel Augustus Ward wrote the words for it, America the Beautiful. But the arrangement is the guy who directed a band in a shell just like this. His name is Carmen Dragon. And he was for many years the orchestra director of the Hollywood Bowl Orchestra. And it's his arrangement of America the Beautiful. Carmen Dragon's arrangement of America the Beautiful. Just a fantastic arrangement. And I thank the band for playing it that way. It's just gorgeous. Oh, man. It's a little work to do that. Okay. We're almost to the end of the hour, aren't we? Okay, yeah, it's good timing here. We're going to end with Stars and Stripes Forever. And we didn't quite do this right, did we, band? Well, we're going to do it anyway. We should have put our national anthem up front, because we usually don't do a lot after the Stars and Stripes, and we'll break the rule tonight. Stars and Stripes Forever, March, John Philip Sousa, and hopefully a little surprise toward the end. John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes.
Stripes Forever. Thank you.
Okay, we didn't do this right, but thank you.
It's a fantastic march. Okay, you should have started with this because there really isn't anything you can do after Sergeant Stripes Forever, but we will do John Philip Sousa's arrangement of our national anthem, and we'll see some of you maybe Monday night, but next Wednesday back here. I've heard rumors to the effect that we are looking at a new piece of music. It's called Frozen. Anybody ever heard of that? So we're trying to see if we can work it up and play it. It's a very difficult piece and arrangement, but you thought that circus march went fast last week. There's a section in there that goes 192 beats to the minute, or it goes like crazy. But we'll see if we can get it worked up. But right now, join us, please. Have a safe trip home, and please sing along with us our national anthem.